चिल्ड्रन ओपन योर मैथ्स टेक्स्ट बुक पेज नंबर 13. व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ अवर नेक्स्ट लेसन? दैट इज नंबर गिवन इन अ पिक्चर. सो चिल्ड्रन, हियर यू विल बी गिवन टू कॉलम्स, कॉलम ऑफ टेन्स एंड कॉलम ऑफ यूनिट्स. एंड इन दैट कॉलम दे विल गिव यू the picture of the objects. That picture of the objects you have to count and write the name. In the first column they will give you the group of tens, that is tens. So how many groups they will give you, you have to count that group and write it down. And same with the units also, you have to count single objects. Okay, single objects, and you have to write down in units column. That is your number, that is your numeral, and then down you have to write that number name. So see here, they have formed group of tens and units. Here they have made one block of 10. Okay, one group of 10, and here two single block. So that means 1 10 and 2 units. So what is the number name? It's 12. Read after me. TWELVE. It's a 12. Look at the next example. Here they have given two column, not two groups. Here two groups of blocks. This is one group, this is second group. So it is 2 tens. Okay. And how many single blocks we are having? Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, 8 single blocks, that means 8 units we are having here. And what is the number? It's 28. And what is the spelling? TWENTY, 20. And EIGHT, 8. It's 28. So let's go on the next example. See, tens column, units column. In tens column, how many group of blocks you can see? See, first, second, third, and fourth. That means 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 group of blocks we can see. So we have to write 4 number down. And how many single blocks we can see? That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 single blocks we can see. That means 7 units. So 4 tens and 7 units, it's 47. Spell out FORTY, 40, SEVEN, 7. It's 47. So children, did you get how the questions are coming? Question will come. So like that means you will be given the column, tens column and units column. In that columns, you will be given the objects. Then you have to count the group of objects and write the number below. Then in units column, single objects you have to count and write the number below. And then together that number spelling, you have to write it down. So we are going on our next question. What is our next question? Read after me. Look at the pictures and write the numbers in words as well as in numerals. Numeral means number, like this. And down it is called number name. So numeral means above one and number names. Okay. So here, see, can you see the column of tens and units? And here they have shown the string of beads. And in each string, there are 10 beads. Okay. One group of 10. So how many strings we can see? Only one string. That means here we have to write 1 10. And how many singles we can see? 1 2 3 4. So that means 4 units, 4 single beads we are having. Yes or no? So what is the number, children? It's 14. It's FORTEN, it's 14. So in 14, how many tens, children, we are having? In 14, we are having 1 10. And how many units we are having? We are having 4 units. See the next example. Here they have shown the two notes of tens. One group and second group. That means two notes of ten we are having. So it is coming in two tens. And how many single coins we are having? So let's count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So we are having 8 coins over here. So what is the number, children? It's 28. So let's write, it's 20. TWENTY. 20 and 8. EIGHT. It's 28. Did you get? In 28, how many tens, children? In 28, 2 tens are there and 8 units are there. So we'll go on our next example. See, can you see the sticks, bundle of sticks? How many bundle of sticks are here? Let us count. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 4 bundle of sticks. Each bundle is having 10 sticks. Okay. Now how many loose or single sticks we are having? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 7 single sticks we are having. So what is the number? It's 46. So let's write over here. It's 46. F-O-R-T-Y. 40 and 6. Sorry. 47. Sorry. S-E-V-E-N. It's 47. Children, did you get? Children, read the next question. Write the proper number in the blank space. Here they have given the group of tens and units. So how many group of tens? See here, two string of beads. Can you see, children? And how many loose beads they have given? Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means 2 tens and 6 units. It's 26. Then see the next one. Here, how many strings of beads we can see? Only one group. Only one string of beads. That means one group. So it is 1, 10. And how many units? 1, 2, 3. 3 single beads. So it's 13. What is the name? It's 13. T-H-I-R-T-E-E-N. It's 13. And in 13, how many tens? In 13, there is 1 ten. And how many units? There are 3 units. Okay. See the next. So in tens column, how many bundle of sticks you can see, children? So we can see 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 bundle of sticks. That means 4 tens, 40. And how many single sticks we can see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 single stick we can see. It's 45. So spell F-O-R-T-Y, 40 and 5. F-I-V-E, 5, 45. Now tell me, in 45, how many tens are there? In 45, there are 4 tens. And how many units are there? There are 5 units. Children, did you get this page? Then we'll turn our next page. See, read out the question. Page number 14. Look at the objects, count them and write their number in the circle below. Now, here already they have written the number. So what we are going to do? We are going to write the whole number here. Here we have made the columns of tens and units, but here we have to write the whole number. So how many group of blocks you can see here? Here 3 groups of blocks we can see. See 1, 2 and 3. That means 3 tens. And how many units? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 single blocks. So 4 units. And what is the number? It's 34. So we have to write here 3 and 4. 3 tens, 4 units, 34. See here, how many group of blocks we can see in the tens column? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So it's 5 ten, 5 group of blocks. How many single blocks we can see? 1, 2 and 3. It's 3. So single 3 blocks we can see. And what is the number? It's 53. It's 53. And in 53, how many tens? In 53, there are 5 tens and there is 3 units. Can you see, children? Now see the next example. In this example, how many blocks of groups we can see? See, count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 4 group of blocks. And then single blocks are how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 single blocks. So what is the total number? It's 45. And in 45, children, how many tens are there? There is 4 tens and there is 5 units. So children, did you get? So read out the next question. See, read the numbers and show the same number of the things. So here they have given the number. What you have to do? You have to draw here, and it's a homework for you. Okay, this thing you have to do. What is there to draw? See, by looking at the number, you can draw the string of beads. Singles and string of beads means, you know, now here, see, this is called here. I'll show you behind. It is called string of beads. Okay, this is called string of beads. It is bundle of sticks. So you can draw like that. String of beads in tens column and single beads in units column, or bundle of sticks in tens column or single sticks in units column. Then what is the number, children? It's 39. So you are going to do here 3 string of beads. Okay, 3 string of beads you are going to draw here, and single 9 beads you are going to draw. If you cannot draw like this, you have to draw the straight line, straight single line, and in each line there are 10 beads. You are going to draw like this. Okay, there are 10 beads like that. You have to draw. It's a homework for you. And here you are going to draw the single bead. Single means like this. So total units place, how many beads you will draw? 9 beads. And in tens column, how many strings of 10 you will draw? So 3 string of 10 you will draw. Then we'll go on the next. See 41. In 41, how many string of beads or bundle of sticks you will draw? So 4 tens. 4 ten means either you can draw 4 string of beads or you can show 4 bundle of sticks. Okay. And units column, only 1. 1 stick or 1 bead. Did you get, children? Then see the next example. It's 22. So in 22, you are going to draw here 2 string of beads or 2 bundle of sticks. And units column, 2 single sticks or 2 single beads. It is the homework for you. You have to do it in your textbook. If you don't have children textbook, draw this in your rough notebook. Did you get? So keep practicing, keep solving the sums which I taught you today, and do count the things in groups and go this page number 13 and page number 14 again and show to your parents. The homework which you will do, you have to show to your parent. Till that, stay safe at home. Good day and goodbye.